Gynester, it is a half-RD annual. It has refloret and disfloret. This is the disfloret and this is the refloret. Disfloret are usually hermaphrodite and refloret are, florets are pistillate. In terms of annual flowers, it ranks next to chrysanthemum and marigold. Seed rate is 2.5 to 3 kg, again very very important. And Astra Yellow, as my friend Parvati also mentioned yesterday, it is caused by phytoplasma and the transmitter is yellow hopper, leaf hopper. It is a self-pollinated crop, Gynester. Here we can find the Gaetonogamous. Gaetonogamous is in the single plant itself, one pollination of one flower may pollinate the other flower. Hello, are you all getting it? What happens in Gaetonogamous conditions? In the same plant, one flower from one flower may pollinate the other flower, but in the same plant. So it is a self-pollinated condition. This kind of conditions it is found in Gynester. And pure yellow color is still not available in Gynester yet. And it comes into blooming usually after 3.5 to 4 months of transplanting. Varieties developed from IHR, Kamini, Purnima, Shashank, Violet Kushan, Arka Aradhya, Arka Arjuna, white color. So there are some of the varieties in Gynester that is produced, that is developed from MPKB Rowry, that is Fully Ganesh Pink, Fully Ganesh Yellow and all, Fully Ganesh Purple and all. You can go to their website. So this this was all about the major cut flowers and the loose flowers, and as I have been seeing, sometimes they ask direct questions in terms of physiological disorders. Though I have mentioned these disorders in respective PPTs also, but just to amalgamate into one table, I have put this table. You can go through later. We have major physiological disorders in case of rose. We have bullhead due to the insufficient carbohydrates or even heart pruning and trips. This is the image of the bullhead, a physiological disorder. Even trip infestations may lead to the bullhead conditions in rose. And we have bent neck. It is mostly a post-harvest disorder. It will be either due to the deficiency of water in the neck. I mean, like water won't be able to reach it to the butt due to the vascular plugging. So that may lead to the bent neck. And we have blind shoot. It is usually bud abortion. We may not get flower in the stem, or even if it's there, then that is not marketable. And in terms of gladiolus, we have fluoride toxicity. So gladiolus is also called as a fluoride indicator plant. And fluoride indicator plant, and that is why gladiolus is usually not recommended to go for planting around the industrial areas. And we have again very important disorder in gladiolus, topple or bud rot, due to the deficiency of calcium. And we have geotropism. As I said yesterday also, it is due to the uneven distribution of auxin. As you know, auxin, it has a it travels in a bicipital fashion. So when its distribution is uneven, it leads to the geotropism. And geotropism, this condition is also found in other flower like Antirrhinomyces, which is also called snapdragon, and even in lupin also. That is why vertical transportations or vertical placement of this flower is very important. Then we have calyx splitting, as you can see here in the picture also. It is due to the low temperature. When the temperature is usually lesser than 10 degrees centigrade, that may lead to the calyx splitting. What happens is there will be growth of extra rolls inside the calyx. So that may lead to the splitting of it. And we have slab slide. that is like bud protrudes to the one side, and grassiness it is mostly zenity, and sleepiness it is due to the presence of high ethylene. Yes, yesterday also I said ethylene it is a carnation, it is a very ethylene sensitive plant. So for Lilium we have leaf scorch, bud blast, puffy foliage due to the frost injury. And in terms of orchid, we have sepal dry sepal injury or deformed flowers or brown throat. And in case of Astromeria we have chalking, mainly due to poor handling or storage in humid conditions, or even when bulbs are exposed to the sunlight. And there are some of the speciality flowers. Speciality flowers are the flowers that are having unique features, so that can be grown in the garden. There are many speciality flowers, but most of which this Butter Paradise and Heliconia are important, because I have seen some of the questions from these two crop. So I thought I'll just put it here. Butter Paradise, it is also called crane flower. Scientific name is Strelitzia resini. I have not mentioned, one can note it down. Strelitzia resini, and it belongs to family Strelitziaceae, and it is originated in South Africa, and its chromosome number is 14. It is mostly a herbaceous perennial plant, and pollination is done through bird, that is ornithophilia. And there is one species, Strelitzia resini variety humilis. It is grown for the, it is suitable for container growing. And this actually what you see, this greenish part, it is a bract, and these are the flowers. And yeah, and a yield, it usually gives after 3 years of planting, and it produces usually 1 to 3 spikes per plant. And storage, this is again a tropical flower, so storage temperature is quite higher than the other normal flowers. So storage, it can be, we can do it at 10 degrees centigrade for 4 days, and its base life is usually 7 to 8 days. Now we have this Heliconia. What you can see in the picture is Heliconia rostrata. Again, it has many species. Sorry, I was not, I couldn't put all the images. Heliconia, it belongs to family Heliconiaceae, and it is originated in Central and South America. It is also called lobster, claw, parrot flower, parrot plantain, or false plantain. And in India, 50% of production of Heliconia come from the West Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh. So this much for Heliconia.